Now each team consists 3 students from Singapore and 3 students from India. We'll paving way for cultural and technical idea exchange also. And they are continuously work for next 36 hours without sleeping.
We identified both the participants, of Singaporean participants and Indian participants, about 1.5 months in advance. Even the mentors, and they were allocated the problem statements. They were knowing each other, so they were continuously talking to each other over Skype and WebExes. And what should be the strategy? How should they move ahead? And majority of them are coming with that strategy in mind, and now they will just work for the next 36 hours and execute that strategy.
Right, this is just to show that idea that you can be a game change agent and you can be the change that you want to see, not that you have to wait for others to do it. And very often we find that the best progress and ideas come when different diverse people get to it.
India has to now tap talent from around the world. This is the way of integrating. We will tap talent from Singapore, from other places, and our talent, of course, will be the front, and we'll have to mix them up to try to come up with innovations which can solve all the problems of the country. That is what we need to do going forward. And this is a very important step in that direction.
Yes.
But any institution is not complete just with education. What you need is education, research, and innovation. So in this concept, this hackathon is working as a second stage after the education. When you're after the research, now the innovation is coming in, startup and other things. If we find good solutions to solve the common problems, we can move into the innovation stage. That's how this is going to help us. But NTU invested heavily, not only on the teaching, research, innovation, and internationalization. In the internationalization aspect, particularly, we have a very special program, what is called as NTU India Connect. NTU India Connect. The objective of this particular program or initiative is to connect the Indian universities and institutes of higher learning and NTU together. How do we connect them? Bring the young students from one country to another, make them to do the collaborative research, and at the end of the day, they have some common interest in solving the problems. The most important point is we are in the globalized world, and no single country can solve all the problems, and the problems and experiences are different for different countries. Singapore is a relatively small and technologically highly advanced country, and India is very large, very diverse, with a variety of problems and variety of resources, particularly young population. Now the idea of bringing these two people together is to solve the same problem. What is the perspective of the people from the different countries? Because that makes a very big difference. One solution is not enough for all countries. The problem may be same, but the solution will not be same. So we have to look from that point of view. That is why we thought it is better to bring the students from both countries together beforehand so that they can share their thoughts and work together to find a common solution which could be used in both countries or even the world as a whole.
When students take up problems which are challenging problems for the society and try to solve them, and they come out with brilliant solutions, naturally all of us will feel happy about it, and that's what is visible here. This program is very, very interesting from many aspects. The first one is industry always talks about students not employable, and therefore how do we increase their employability? So this is one platform where multiple things which industry is looking for are available. First thing which industry also talks about is problem solving ability. In industry, every day there is new issue, new problem. How people who are employed will be able to solve the problem? So here in this hackathon, there are some problem statements given and students will start thinking about those problems. So ability to think critically about that issue, analyzing the problem, synthesizing the solution, and then trying to actually implement. So this is all a series of steps for problem solving. And every student who participates in hackathon is doing that. Secondly, as you know, one of the other things which industry says, the second one, is communication skills. Many times students may have all the knowledge, but they are not able to express, they are not able to use. So here is a platform where students have to necessarily be able to express, because when they first submit their solutions, they have to submit the solution in a written form. So the ability to write report, write the solution is first thing. Second thing, when they come here and during the interaction, there must be verbal communication. They must be able to speak out what they know, and only then they will be able to address. So that is another communication. And then teamwork, which is also very important in industry. So there are six people, how do they work together? And this time, it is not just one country team, but there are teams formed by citizens of two countries. So how you actually engage with another country and students of another country is another interesting issue which is going to be satisfied through this. Then lastly, time management. You know, industry wants everything to be within time. And when the limit is specified that within 36 hours you have to get the solution, the students have to plan their whole journey and how they can solve this problem within this stipulated time. So you talk about any of the aspects which industry needs, they are all provided in steps through this hackathon.
First thing first, I must correct you, it's not Asia's, it's world's biggest right. Open innovation model. And we already reached close to the number like 2.75 to 3 lakh last year. And in itself is a big achievement. And this year, as you mentioned, year on year we are improving, we are going bigger, better, grander as well. So now what we planned, how to reach to the bottom level of the student, how can we do that? So this year what we are planning that every college or institution, they will organize their own hackathon. And then they will submit the top five teams out of their college. It can be a mix of four teams plus one student innovation or all five the winning teams. So what will happen? So target is last year we had 2,235 colleges. This year at least we are targeting 3,000 to 4,000 colleges. And if they organize their internal hackathon, so you can imagine the traction. And once they, and we have designed the time frame, like from 31st of October to 31st of December, during those 2 months, they have to organize internal hackathon. This is also aligned with IIC, Institute Innovation Council's activity as well, so that they can get the due credit. Also, this is aligned with their internships, so that students, if they are participating for 5 days, they will get due credit in their internship. So we are trying to develop an ecosystem. And SH 2020, as such, now we are moving with central ministries. Now state governments again ripped in. Companies, they are already lined up. So that's all. And I'm sure this time we may cross 5 lakh, God knows. Nothing. So my only point, what I would like to say, innovation, it doesn't come out of your books. It's like from your inner sense. Try to look around. Don't be a rat in the rat race. Just hold on, hold your breath. Look why these rats are running. Look why everything is moving around. Think from a different perspective. I believe the innovation has that basic key sense. Roadside vendor, they are also innovative. Your mother is the most innovative fellow you can find anywhere in the home side. So be open, like keep your eyes and ear open. Try to solve the solutions which we all are facing. If you can become that, I believe you are a true innovator. Make our lives easy. That is the simple philosophy I believe for an innovation has to be.
We have enough potential youth with us having very good innovative idea, and they are very much efficient in bringing solution for a particular problem within the stipulated time. And I judged two problem solutions. One, it was the indoor air quality problem solution. Another one is hospital waste management solution. And always all the team was very, very efficient and innovative, very smart students. And the whole solution they are bringing is very innovative and cost effective. It can be implemented. And I, this time I congratulating MHRD, AICTE and Innovation Cell for the initiative to bring the youth to the front face of the innovations. And the evaluation was very tough because all the team was very, very smart enough in their particular field. Most of the space covered is in artificial intelligence, IoT, data analytics and everything. I think it was a new subject for the, even though it is a new subject for the students are very much thorough in the in their subject, and the all projects was very important and very useful to the society. It is, this kind of hackathon will be moderate our development of the nation in all sense.
So right now in this session, I judge two teams. One is with the waste management, another one is stress analysis. Because recent times you can see all the news is like how the teams are not able to manage the stresses and many of the people are getting suicide attempts. So these people brought some of the innovative ideas to avoid those type of suicide attempts so that the people, the students can come out of that scenarios. So this was very much innovative things what these fellows are trying to bring out. And I noticed like some of the students are not from the mechanical background, but they're interested to do all the types of things. That's like, for example, the science students are also very much interested to do the mathematics things, and also from engineering point of view. And many people are doing taking the other streams so that they're learning their stuff. That is, they keep on increasing the learning curve from the ground to the higher level. So this was very much innovative one or innovative beginning to make and to cultivate all the knowledges on the students. And this is a platform where the students can explore themselves, exposed to sometimes situations where they can come up with some innovative ideas. So, as I said, Government of India have taken some initiative to bring these types of hackathons by doing collaborative with some other countries so that it will be a nice joint venture and a collaborative work where the students can be very much improve their knowledge, and also they can get a good rapport with other nations where they can share the cultures and also the science establishment what over there.
So I'm mentoring two teams in this hackathon. One team is doing the air quality management. The other team is doing a classroom attentive project. So in this hackathon, I find that it is really very exciting because it is really a combination of two different country, of two different culture, and the people have different way of thinking on solving problem, and yet they are able to work together and jointly solve the problem. And I see that this is really a kind of a very challenging and a very innovative way of having the hackathon. This is really challenging for two team of students from two different schools and from two different country. And I think in Indian team, as far as I understand, even the students are from different universities inside India. So the fact that they can work together in such a short period of time and put their thoughts together, it is really a very positive way for me to see that this is really going to be the future of the world, where you'll be more international and more collaborative between all the different people with different skill set. So I am totally very surprised. It's a positively surprised to see the outcome. And then when I walk around to talk to the students, I found that most of them are really putting the solution together. So I'm really looking forward to see a very wonderful presentation by tomorrow. And then hopefully one of or two of my team will win the prize from this event. So I think that is a really a good, very interesting and very good opportunity.
For myself and Brian, we are actually enrolled in business students, we are banking finance students. We are startup founders as well. We have engineering and computer science experts. So we make a very good and well diversified team over here.
Right? So we devised a crushing mechanism in a mechanical mode which doesn't require electricity and can be operated in a rural areas. Okay, so different various emotions, happy, sad, surprise, confused, head gaze detection, and body posture analysis. All these fit into our own customized and our own very own built customized neural network.
So we propose a one-shot algorithm which basically maps a student's 128 parameters on the basis of one picture.
Once disease, how will that change in each state? Then, of course, with optimal supply chain, you can make the best actions to solve those problems.
Because we're not only using social media to detect the depression, we are also using the grades and the attendance records of the student to verify that the student is in depression.
The most important is that we can make friends, right, from different countries. Right, we didn't know each other, we were strangers, but you know, just through these 2 days, we become such a good friends. We can talk about a lot of things, and we have managed to build a product up from scratch.
Takeaway for me, at least, I think for a lot of people, has been how to approach problems. So you need to. I mean, we have been looking at theoretical aspects of problems, but now, I mean, I think we can also look at practical aspects. So three of us are, I think, PhD students, so we know how to do theoretical work, but practical work is something that I think will be a big takeaway from this hackathon.
The chain went all the way out. We give our best. Everyone did the best of our ability in whatever we are tasked to do. And as a collective group, whatever result we achieve, I guess we sort of deserve it because we really put in the effort and we work as a team. I guess the team dynamics is the most important part. This entire team.
So it was great interacting with our friends from Singapore, and they have been a really great support, and our mentors have tutored us during the entire process, and even before this 36 hours for the last half month, they have been guiding us continuously. And winning this today was the combined efforts of what we started, I guess, a month back, and it has been just an amazing experience for us.
The next game was looking at 0.05 difference, and that's how I think you made a real good effort. You all are the winners. That's the statement I want to make. You all are the winners.